Hello, I'm Derik, a software engineer at Sintasso, and today I'm going to demonstrate how you can leverage Kratix to manage a fleet of clusters and how it can help you automate your day two operations. I have prepared here today in my box, I have four kind clusters. Those clusters could be running anywhere, actually. It doesn't need to be kind, but here's just to demonstrate. So I have a platform cluster where Kratix is actually installed, and I have three other clusters that are my destinations, that are where I can run my workloads. So let's take a look at those. So you can see that in my platform, I have those three destinations currently set up. I also installed a promise, a MongoDB promise. This is providing Mongo as a service. If you're not familiar with Kratix, a promise is a definition, a way to provide anything as a service. I'm not gonna dive deep into like how Kratix actually works behind the scenes, what destinations are, what promises are, but if you are curious and if you don't know about it, you can go to kratix.io. If you click in the docs page, you should find plenty of docs, including more like basic videos of like what a promise is and how Kratix works behind the scenes. But great, so I have this promise and I also sent a few requests. So I created a few instances of those promise, of that promise. So I have four MongoDB clusters, MongoDB deployed across those clusters. So you can see that I have two in the EU, one in the US, one in Asia, all running on different versions. And I can show you the pods as well. So pods is just an alias here that I have to just list all the pods running in all of my kind clusters. So you can see that I have MongoDB running in those different clusters. I also deployed this little app just to show you how those operations and the upgrades will go through. So you can see that right now we have four running MongoDBs, and you can also see what version they are actually running, and you can see what's the version that the platform is expecting them to be. So Kratix works in a multi-cluster environment, so it actually declares what it wants the state to be, and then the system reconciles later on to be on that version that it wants. So during the upgrades, you'll see the desired version changing while the running version, you know, while it is upgraded, the running and the desire will be different, but they will eventually converge to be the same. So great. So I have all of those four instances running. If I'm a platform team managing this platform, I'm happy. I can take a look at it. I see what's going on. But I wake up one morning and I go to MongoDB alerts. I'm checking the security-related vulnerabilities. There is a new one. And I can see that, you know, this affects versions 4.0.14 and prior, 4.4.23 and prior. So if you go back to your dashboards, you're like, here I have a problem. So I have two instances running on vulnerable versions. So both A and C, they are running vulnerable versions of MongoDB. So you need to upgrade. Without Kratix, you may have your own process, but it probably involves going through each one of those instances and manually upgrading them or doing something like that. Kratix allows you to manage that fleet of clusters. So you can imagine if you have tens of thousands of those or tens of hundreds of those, it gets very annoying and very complicated to actually go through and upgrade each one of those things, instances individually. So you probably like stop your operations for a day just to respond to this particular issue. But let's see how you could do it with Kratix. With Kratix, what you have to do, all you have to do is really apply a new version of the promise that is defining the like the desired version to be the new versions. So I already have that in. I'm gonna just go ahead and apply. As soon as I apply, what Kratix will do is take a look at all of my instances and define, do I need to run any pipelines for those? And you can see that the answer is yes. For each one of the instances that we have deployed, Kratix will execute the workflow for like create, then configure a new instance. So you can see that it already run all four of them. If you go back to this dashboard at this point, we can see that Kratix is changing the instances now. So team A is right now on the desired version of 4.4.24, but the version is actually running 4.4.23. So Kratix already told the worker cluster to upgrade this particular instance. The upgrade did not kick off yet. But C, for the other hand, the upgrade already kicked off. So you can see that it's already in an upgrade state. So right now it's upgrading. So if you can take a look at the MongoDBs again, you can see that Kratix is already expecting, is already asking for those versions to be upgraded. You may also notice that the B and D did not change at all. So those versions were not vulnerable. So when my pipeline run, it actually made no changes whatsoever to those particular instances. So those particular instances will continue to be running. We're not going to be affected by anything in particular. So at this point, if I run, get my list of pods again, I can see that my team A is in the process of being upgraded. So the operator that is running here picked up those changes and is now upgrading that instance. The same is happening for instance C. This may take a little bit of time, so let's just take a look and see what's going on. Oh, I can see that they are actually already completed. So if you go back to your dashboard and refresh, you can see that those instances now are all got bumped automatically. So you have team A on 4.424, no longer vulnerable. Team C on 5.015, no longer vulnerable. And the two instances that are not affected, they didn't change at all. So no one actually noticed that there's no difference between what it had before and what it had now. Because the pipeline has this property of being idempotent. If nothing changes, no changes we'll actually see in the other end. And that's pretty much it. So you can imagine if you have many, many instances, how easy it could be for you to upgrade them all with Kratix. Of course, what I did not show is how to control. Maybe you have canary instances. You want some test instances in some namespaces on some clusters you've upgraded first to make sure that it works. You may want windows of time when you actually want the upgrade. You may want to give your users a chance of upgrading themselves. But those are all features that Kratix that are built in with Kratix, and then you can use to further control your upgrades. That's pretty much it. So I hope you enjoyed it. And if you have any questions, don't but please reach out. We are on GitHub at syntasso.org Kratix, or you can also go to syntasso.io or Kratix.io and send us a note. Thanks very much. See you later.